According to the opposition's response to the National Budget Framework paper for the financial year 2023-2024, government offsets over 8 trillion shillings annually in tax exemptions to different companies. Top beneficiaries include Oil Palm Uganda Limited, Roofing's Rolling Mills Limited, Steel and Tube Industries Limited, and Fine Spinners Uganda Limited.
Of course, don't pay this. Now, the total in that sample we have picked is 588 billion. This money is enough to fund literally Uganda Road Fund.
Other companies include Uganda Post Limited, University of Kisubi, Finasi Issue Construction SPV Limited, and International Specialized Hospital Uganda Limited, which were exempted from pay as you earn.
Last year I came here and we agreed in a financial report that we don't pass this year's budget. We need consistency before we have had a report of government on exemption.
With the accruing sums of money lost in tax exemptions, budget committee members called for an audit into government tax waivers to establish the status and impact on the economy.
It indicated that we are spending 8 trillion in debt in tax exemptions. That's a third, 30% of our budget. How is that possible? Are your figures correct? So we need to do this audit. Whatever it was, we need to set up a committee to investigate these tax exemptions.
Where the money is? The facts is here. What are we going to do with these facts? Or we are going to pretend and that we don't know? And our people continue to really be denied the services that they have because we don't have money?
Legislators wondered why government continues to lose over 30% of domestic revenues in tax exemptions amidst revenue shortfalls. They faulted URA for dishing out tax waivers without bothering to carry out a review on the impact on the economy.
Denies us 3 percentage points of debt to GDP ratio.
They have borrowed money from banks and loans are running. You can't just wake up overnight and chase away people.
Recently, Uganda Revenue Authority cried before Parliament of the increased burden of tax exemptions on domestic revenue mobilization, indicating that 2.8 trillion is projected to be lost in tax waivers in the financial year 2023-2024. MPs questioned the criteria under which government continues to offer exemptions on payee.
That means some Ugandans are not paying taxes, individual personal taxes. How can it be that PAYE, which is not paid by the employer, is paid by the employee on what they earn, is being exempt? How can it be?
According to the Ministry of Finance, in the past 3 years, Uganda has forgone 11.7 trillion shillings through tax waivers, but there has been a lack of transparency and inefficiencies in the authorizing environment of tax exemptions. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.